Welcome back to the Blue Door Pub Thunderdome for another Bull with Andy Carlson, Minnesota's 87 The Best Daily Podcast, a show about everything and nothing, coming at you 5 days a week. I'm your captain on this one-hour tour. Follow me on Twitter at Andy Carlson Show and also Instagram. Trying to grow there. Putting in work. Sitting shotgun today on a Friday is Uncle Nick. Follow him on Twitter at Nickerson. Hey.
Hey, happy to be back.
What's your Instagram? I feel like it's at Nickerson.
Yeah, it's at Nickerson.
That's on brand. That is on brand. Tell a friend, spread the word, iTunes, Stitcher, iHeartRadio, and bullshow.co is the website. Happy Friday out there. I want to kick things off. We've been doing
it. What it is? All nice and decent.
Yes. This is Mr. Just bring up some random ass 90s/2000 song that I love. Breathe it in, Nick. What's your other favorite Sugar Ray song?
I'm thinking it might be that Every Morning song. I thought there was another one, but I cannot think of it off the top of my head.
All around the world, statues crumble for me. Who knows how long I loved you. I got the CD for Christmas. Let's see, the year it came out, 1997. So I would have been 12. Oh, here it is. Put your arms around me, baby. Put your arms around me, baby.
I just wanna fly. Where you want, where you try, where you want.
Put your arms around me, baby. Put your arms around me, baby. It still lists Mark McGrath as a member of the band, like a current member. Past members, DJ Homicide. He's gone.
He's gone?
No. What happened to DJ Homicide?
I assuming...
Creative differences?
Assuming fast food job now or
hey
something.
Hey man, we're getting the band back together.
Oh my god, I'm watching the music video and other people are singing that's not Mark McGrath.
Well, I think that's just the video. Yeah, it's kind of cool how Mark McGrath went from the sort of trashy ska punk lead singer of a band douchebag with the goatee and soul patch to he's still basically that, but he's on TV for other stuff.
There are no words, but you know the 90s are really doing a really big resurgence.
Well, I was having this thought in the shower. You ever have great thoughts in the shower? Not sexual, just like epiphanies. But boy bands are really smart when they started creating them because they didn't come together organically. It wasn't like five very different cute kids came together. It was like, hey, man, you want to start a band? Yeah. No, they're put together by that stupid Lou Pearl or whatever his name is.
Lou Pearlman.
Yeah, like really skeevy, scummy-ass dudes who just want to flip a buck and are probably into little kids. And, you know, they put them together, and then they toured, and they put them in dance classes and singing classes and choreography, and they knew that they were going to cash in on the 10 to 14, 15-year-old girl market, and you'll hit them again later on once they have disposable income in their late 20s and 30s when you get the band back together and start touring arenas again. It's brilliant.
What happened with the Backstreet Boys, NSYNC, with the Slew guy, is that the boy band guys, they grew up and they fought back because they were taking money straight out right away. I think the Backstreet Boys, I think on their first or second album, only got thousands of dollars. But Lou got the millions, you know. I mean, the record
company...
Well,
they had to divide it five ways.
Still, though, it's almost like a, I want to use the word pyramid scheme, but, you know, you have Lou who just gets them all together and, you know, I'm sure he does some work for it, but, you know, the Backstreet Boys, I mean, I think in his mind, he thinks that the Backstreet Boys, like, the fame is all they want, but, you know, they got to pay bills, too. I mean, if they...
Well, it's sort of a microcosm of what happens in movies. You see that Tom Cruise or Tom Hanks or Will Smith gets $20 million for this movie. You're like, holy shit, that's a lot of money. But then you see that the movie grosses $800 million, and it's like, the studios and the financial backers are getting all that money. But still, $20 million in fame. nothing to sneeze at. Exactly what's going on with this.
I really think, though, the Backstreet Boys got, like, only thousands of dollars, yeah. though, which is insane.
Who's your favorite Backstreet Boy?
I couldn't tell any of them.
Timberlake.
No, that's NSYNC.
That was a test and you failed. Tell me why. I'm not going to lie. When I'm driving, sometimes I will put this on the Amazon Music, and I will effing just rip it. Just go at it. Like, not even give two shits.
I'm not ashamed to admit it. I always liked them. These are fun. These are pop songs. They're fun to sing along with. NSYNC, the Bye Bye Bye. It's fun to do the hand motions. I know you guys know how to do the hand motions.
Yeah. Oh, back when Timberlake had the ramen noodle hair?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, all right. So over under 5.5 writers on this song.
Over.
Under 2.
Really?
Yeah. What's the example they always go to? Baby. Baby. I'm trying to, talk.
You mean Justin Bieber's song?
Yeah, Justin
Baby.
Bieber's song. Yeah.
Baby. Don't tell me there was like half a dozen writers.
Because it's a meme, because that was Freddie Mercury wrote Bohemian Rhapsody, and then Justin Bieber's Baby, there was like 22 writers on it. Yeah.
It's not surprising. I mean, there's a lot of collaborations, and it's probably better that they have some credit at some point, because it sucks when it's a band. And like for the Beatles, for example, if John and Paul are doing a lot of the writing and then George or Ringo try to put in one or two words and then the song becomes a big hit, George and Ringo will want some credit too.
One of the writers on the song was Terrius Yongdell Nash, whose stage name is The... The Dash Dream. So, when they put it alphabetical order, would it be The Dreams Dashed?
No, I think. You know what sucks is when he dies, it's going to be The Dream Has Died.
Well, I don't know if he'll be that famous to get headlines of, but what I want to know is how does this start? Like, how do you get the nickname The Dream Do you give it to yourself? Because like Hakeem Olajuwon's nickname was The Dream, except it was very easy because his name was Hakeem. It rhymes with dream, and he definitely didn't give it to himself. He didn't give two shits about nicknames. But I wonder if Terrius Yongdell Nash nicknamed himself The Dream.
What's his profession? I'm sorry.
That is a good looking
question.
Is a singer, songwriter, record producer, which means probably waiting tables, and his co-writing credits include Dear Jane, Me Against the Music for Britney Spears, Umbrella for Rihanna, Single Ladies, Put a Ring on It for Beyonce, and Baby for Justin Bieber. Maybe I'm just trashing this guy and he's got some chops.
It's a very underrated profession that a lot of people don't know about is the songwriters. There are many songwriters. I've done nights where I was on Wikipedia looking up different songwriters. There's a lot of great hit songs. And, thankfully, a lot of musicians do give credit where it's due, and they use the same songwriter more than once to help create these albums.
Because wasn't that what Coyote Ugly was all about? She wanted to be a songwriter?
Yes.
Because that was kind of a weird twist on the whole, I want to be famous. Dad, I want to be a singer. Her dad's got John Goodman, wasn't he?
Yeah, I that might have been one of my first real, like, crush movies. I crushed on Piper Perato so hard in that movie. And that song was actually pretty catchy. The Can't Fight the Moonlight.
Now, this song is catchy as hell. This song reminds me of college and just getting drunk and grinding up on chicks at Shides. Which is,
oh my God.
Nick knows what Shides is. If you don't know what Shides is, Shides was this really dirty ass college bar in Winona, Minnesota, where Nick and I went to school. And yeah, it got shut down for tax evasion.
And I think there were a lot of stabbings in recent years when they tried bringing it back. Well, it was where all the bad kids went.
Well, there's a couple of stabbings. Our buddy Tyler got roughed up in the parking lot a little bit.
That's what I probably saw.
Well, my whole thing is that I was out of town that weekend, and I'm glad I was, because, like, oh, shit. I don't want to... Like, I would feel bad watching, but not as bad as I would getting involved in a fight, because I'm not a fighter. I'm a lover, not a fighter. I would have just watched. Or I've been like, you know, every fight video now, the background track is some dude going like, hey. I follow the Twitter account 30 Second Fights. And it's hilarious. A lot of times it's like schoolyard fights, like the kid finally stands up to the bully. He's been taking jiu-jitsu classes, gets the bully in the arm bar. It's awesome, right? Or it's two chicks in Walmart parking lot going at it. It's crazy. And everyone's always filming, and there's always one guy in the background going, hey.
That's not what a society should go to.
That's what it should go to. I probably should mention, we have a lovely edition of Russia or Wisconsin coming up. Allie, producer Allie, has now done herself. We're going to have some good times there. But I wanted to bitch about this. The destination bachelor or bachelorette party. Thoughts on that?
Wow. It's rough. It's rough to try to do if there's a lot of money. And, you know, you don't know the financial.
Yeah.
Point of it, how far is it from the wedding, and like, is a wedding destination as well?
Yeah,
that'd be a good question. My good friends, hi Kate, hey Cassie, they're doing a destination bachelorette party for her down in Florida, but the wedding is going to be this weekend. So, I mean, in that case, that case, it kind of works, because. Yeah. If it's going to be a destination wedding that everyone can be involved in,
yeah.
They can take that, you know, if they can afford to take that week off, they'll take that week off to go down there. It's hard, though. It's, you know, not everyone's, you know, making six figures, you know, it can, there could be high budget issues.
Well, my whole thing is that when people get married, they're still relatively young. We're not talking about second marriage bachelor parties, because by then you've made some scratch. You probably lost half in the divorce, but it's okay. And your kids don't talk to you, and you hate your life. But that's when you go to Vegas. But when you're a young professional, you're like 24, 25, 26 years old, you're getting married. Some of your friends, maybe they're in grad school, maybe they're still a barista, maybe they're still bartending. You know, not everyone has $1,500 to drop on a long 4-day weekend in Vegas. And I get it. It's the whole. This is my last hurrah, even though we have a 52% divorce rate in the United States. This is my last hurrah. This is my last weekend as a free man. Or, no, it's even worse with the bachelorette parties. Oh, my God. This is my last weekend as a free woman, you guys. So, it's like the Family Guy sketch. So, we're going to go to Montreal. we have to go somewhere completely a pain in the ass to get to and expensive. Yeah, because it's a little bit of... Well, it's definitely a bit of narcissism and the whole bridezilla thing. And this can happen in men, too, so to not to be sexist. But you know, everything revolves around you. And sure, you'll have fun. But I do feel bachelor parties are a little overrated.
That's so funny. I'm doing a bachelor party next month.
I bet it sucks.
No.
No, I bet you'll be fine.
No, I will be doing one next month. Yeah, you know... I'm trying to. I'm single, so I can't wait till I get married.
Yep.
And
oh,
I'm trying.
Well,
to,
hell, we should talk about my bachelor party, which you were the best man and you put on.
I was kind of there.
So what did we do?
I don't remember. It was so long ago. No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding. Got a group of us together in the Twin Cities. We were all. Let me think. What year was that? 2008, 2009.
I should probably know, but I don't know.
Anyway.
I know that's 7 this year.
So Minnesota, relatively where everyone who's involved with our wedding, you know, live. So it wasn't too hard to get to. We were in Minneapolis. We attended, I believe, one Twins game. And then we hit up a bunch of bars and strip clubs.
Yeah, well, it was a Twins game. It was part of a doubleheader. And then we watched the second game at the strip club, which was, you could tell it was starting to annoy the strippers. Because the strip club we went to has a big-ass TV that was showing the second game, and we were just all watching, and they're like, oh, my God, look at me. I need to get like $6 to get the suture out. Yeah. And
it's not that bad.
It was a great time. We were on a school bus downtown Minneapolis. Got a hotel. That's really all it needs to be. I feel like you have the equal amount of fun whether you're in a central location where a lot of people are or if you're on destination one. Now, destination-wise, get a cabin, make a weekend out of it, go camping if that's your thing. Hell yeah. That is a lot of fun. Oh, I've done that. You were on one like that recently.
Yep. My buddy Rick, who got married in the fall, last fall, we did one. In the summer, we went up to northern Minnesota. A lot of us all live in the Twin Cities, so we all carpooled. Simple, you know, as long as you keep it organized, so, you know, to control the cost, if cost was a problem, you know, I was saving my pennies back then, so money was tight.
And I get it. This is supposed to be your thing, but if you have a destination wedding on top of a destination bachelorette or a bachelor party, you're a dick. Or a B. That is all. Or a C. I'll go C there.
You're going to go C there?
I'll drop the C. Something I'm also going to drop is shopping on Amazon, bullshow.co/Amazon. And hey, easiest way to support the show because something you already do. I'm going to pick me up a nice little camera. Got my eye on the Canon Rebel. Yeah, the Andre Agassi. Remember when he did camera commercials?
Yeah.
Canon Rebel. Still sticking with me. So we're going to do that through Amazon, through our link, and put a couple nickels in our pocket and keep the independent worship moving on along. Do that up as well. Bullshow.co/Amazon. Take it right to the homepage. Bookmark it. All right, Nick, are you ready to get your ass kicked in yet another game? I think you've only won one game overall.
I won one game overall.
And that was how old they be. And that was a fluke.
Whatever.
That was bullshit.
I wasn't too bad. I wasn't too bad. I think I did pretty good.
Wisconsin or Russia?
Now, it's time to play.
Well, a Wisconsin couple in court today on charges that they were so drunk that they allowed their 9-year-old child to drive their truck.
I mean, that guy's going to be Brett Favre.
He does.
Wait, hold on. Because that was the Fox 9 anchor guy that we got that audio from. I love the condescending because they were so drunk. So drunk.
Wisconsin or Russia?
Now, if you're new to the game, it's pretty straightforward. Allie sends us headlines, and she hides the answer. And we have to guess from the headline if this story occurred in Russia or Wisconsin. Because there's a lot of similarities between the two. Cold, desolate, chubby women, big drinking problem, and communism. Wait, no. They're not communists anymore. They're more just autocrats. Yeah. Who's Wisconsin's autocrat? Aaron Rodgers? Yeah. We'll go with that.
I was going to go more with their governor, but...
Oh, by the way, how awesome is it going to be when Olivia Munn, since they broke up, her and Aaron, just run straight forward to Jordan Rodgers and they just start banging it out?
Isn't he still with the woman that he's...
How long do those last?
I think only one lasted. Out of all the Bachelor and Bachelorettes, I think only one or two actually worked out.
Yeah. All right. So let's get the pyramid music going. Da-da-da-da-da-da. All right. So first one, we'll alternate. I'll go first, since I'm a gentleman. First headline of Wisconsin or Russia. A man tries to kill his rival for a woman's affection by building a bomb, placing it on the street where his rival lived, and detonating it remotely with the help of a camera. There's so many layers to this. All right. So I'm going first. You write down your answer, Nick. All right. So I feel like this is Russia because I don't think anyone in Wisconsin is technologically savvy enough to build a bomb on basically what they used in Dallas to kill the cop killer. They put a bomb on like one of those little remote control cars. So I'm going to say Russia.
I, too, has also said Russia.
Da. Answer is Russia. Hey. All right, so we both have un punto. Number two out of seven today. A 21-year-old man will spend up to 6 years in a mental institution for intentionally crashing his car into a police vehicle. So, Nick, you're first on this.
All right.
Talk through your rationale.
This sounds very typical in any United States. I'm definitely going to go with Wisconsin on this one because I feel like in Russia, anyone, they would just assassinate them. They wouldn't put him on an institution at all. I feel like Wisconsin will be the place to go.
Yeah, except they did making a murder in Wisconsin. And I feel like institutionalizing is more prevalent in the former Eastern Bloc countries. So I'm going to say Russia. So here we go. Answer is Wisconsin. Oh, yes. No.
I'm finally winning at something.
It's not life.
My life is okay.
You're single. You're all right. Next up, a university student tries to edutain people by dressing as a mermaid. She wants to raise awareness of the importance of protecting our rivers, lakes, and oceans while also reclaiming the idea of the mermaid, a construct of the imagination of male sailors, and a woman's body as her own. So, Wisconsin or Russia. This seems like a straight-up UW-Madison thing. So, I'm not even going to blank. I'm going to say Wisconsin.
I agree, too, because I feel like in Russia, they would use the... they wouldn't use the word university. They would use something else, I think. They would call something.
Da. Answer is Wisconsin. Yes. Yay. Under St. Croix. Nah, doesn't matter. Oh, it's in Hudson. Next up, halfway there, number four, headline. Enraged that his wife would change her last name as part of a grocery store promotion, a man drives his wife's car to the grocery store and fills it with concrete. So, Nick, you're up first.
I can't stop. I'm picturing it right now. Gosh, that sounds very interesting.
This seems crazy even for Wisconsin.
Did you say a promotion or something for a grocery store? I mean, local stuff, I can kind of see that. If it's something that... prevalent. I mean, if it was a national chain, I feel like we would have heard about this. Like if someone, so this would have to be small town local. Yep. If it was be in Wisconsin, you know what? I'm just gonna take a stab in the dark. I think I'm gonna do a 180 and call it Russia. I feel like Russian men have grudges, and if you don't obey, I think they would do this to you.
All right,
I
go Russia. Nick says Russia. I'm going to go Wisconsin. I got some ground to make up. Answer is Russia. No.
Yes.
All right, so I got a rally. I got to make them here. Three to go. Headline. A senior citizen has become a viral video sensation thanks to her homemade green screen. Homemade green screen. So like what the weather people use. All right, so I'm going first. I feel like Wisconsin people aren't this technologically savvy again, so I'm going to say Russia.
I said Russia, too.
Answer is Russia. Hey. Two go in Wisconsin or Russia, and I got a sweep. Claiming the government is a gang of terrorists, a man stole 18 guns from the Armageddon gun store. Police found his vehicle on fire and a 161-page crazy-ass manifesto. So, Nick? You're up first.
He's crazy. This sounds like something someone like a redneck would do in the country or something. Yeah. I am going Wisconsin on this one. Hardcore. I don't think. Yeah, Russia. He would have been dead.
I'm really pissed off because I know the answer is Wisconsin. Except from a game theory perspective, I have to pick Russia. So I'm just driving to a ditch. Answer is Wisconsin. Yes. Yeah, because he was the guy who was going after Trump.
Really?
Yeah. Like, they couldn't find him. They might have found him. Doesn't matter. And last but not least, a free skate. Nick's got this locked up. It's all right. A cancer treatment center tries to bring patients joy with candy dioramas. Staff members create candy dioramas, bring them to the treatment center, and patients get to view the dioramas and vote on which ones are best. First off, this sounds stupid. But hey, if it brings them joy, that's fine. How about you just give the cancer people candy? How about that? What does that have to be diorama form?
I don't know what diorama is. So just like
it's
like
a thing that
it?
You're supposed to do in fifth grade, except you didn't, and you got a D. You know why I got a D? Because they don't want to give you an F, because then she would get you in the same grade again next year. Yeah, yeah. I feel like Russians aren't this touchy-feely, so I'm going to say Wisconsin.
I'm going Russia on this one. I feel like they got to try to be somewhat nice once a year.
Answer is Wisconsin.
Oh.
It's okay, Nick. By a score of 5-3, Nick has taken this game.
You love me. You really like me. I'm so happy.
Yeah, but hey, guess what you won?
You get nothing. You lose. Good day, sir.
Whoa. Aww.
It's okay. It's okay, Nick. And that was, we got an outro. That was Wisconsin or Russia.
In Soviet Russia, car drives you.
I've discovered that you people apparently have some sort of federal grant for drinking.
Would you want to visit Russia?
Yes.
Right now?
I wouldn't mind right now, no, not at all. I think it'd be a beautiful.
Even as everyone is out there chicken littling it, we're on the verge of World War III. You're like, F it. I want to go to there.
I respect all cultures, all countries, and I think it's every human's right to try to visit all of them as you can. And you know, I'm a big fan of Russia had a lot of good things. Tattoo, one of my favorite bands.
Oh,
remember Tattoo? T-A-T-U?
No, I don't.
They were the act. Going out of high school. They were the girl act who their little gimmick was that they made out with each other.
Oh, that doesn't seem like a gimmick. That's just good marketing.
It was an awesome marketing. The song played all the time on the radio.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I vaguely remember this.
We're doing promotions. They came through America, and they would sing this song, and then during the halfway break, they would go and make out with each other, and then go back and finish their song. It was brilliant.
2008.
No, it was way older than that. It was early 2000s.
Duh. Up to the stage now, Svetlana and Potato.
The names were Yulia and Lena. I follow Lena.
Are they still together?
No. They're like on a hiatus. They're kind of doing solo careers.
Yeah, I'm sure that's going well.
In Russia, it is. Yeah.
Hey, you know, it's funny. We make fun of box office bombs like Great Wall, Matt Damon's Great Wall, box office bomb, except it grossed a significant amount of money because people internationally will watch anything.
I believe that.
Yeah. Or like a lot of Fast and the Furious franchises' money is made overseas, like China, Japan, etc.
I believe it. But even having my little concept of how movies can work is that if a movie is listed so bad, people want to see it because a lot of people want to see really bad movies, though.
Or it's like ironically bad, like Sharknado. They just hit it right square on the head.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're on like their fourth or fifth one now.
Ugh. Yeah. And now they're just turning to entourages. See how many celebrity camos we can push in. Yeah, it's kind of dumb.
And people do it for money.
But not dumb. It's going to be Thor Ragnarok trailer. We'll watch that when we come back. More Bull with Andy Carlson on Friday. Andy Carlson here, Purple for the Win podcast, letting you know that we'll be here all off-season long talking the Vikings angle on everything. Combine, pro days, free agency, the draft, OTAs, training camp in 2017. Baby. Get the show on 1500 ESPN Podcast 1 and the Podcast 1 app. And coming back into the Blue Door above Thunderdome, and Nick, I gotta tell you, a new sponsor on the show, something that's near and dear to my heart and my lady's thighs, if you know what I mean, The Enclosed, the world's finest panty delivery company and men. So easy. It's like all those meal delivery services that you hear about all the time. It's like, oh, you get it delivered to your door and you cook it. Well, this gets delivered and you don't have to cook it. Although you can eat some of these. You don't have to cook them. You just put them on. Just put them on. And here's what you do. You list your preferences. What do you like? Do you like lacy? Do you like tight? Do you like a little revealing? And then every single month, you get a brand new pair and a couple personalized gifts as well. All occasions, anniversary, birthday, bridal, date night, Mother's Day, if you're into that. And if you use the code PFTW, that's right, just like purple FTW, PFTW, at checkout, you get $15 off any order. That is a huge ass savings. Nick, you're getting all in on this. Who are you going to send the panties to?
I have a couple names in mind.
TheEnclosed.com, TheEnclosed.com, all one word. And remember, PFTW, $15 off any order. Yeah. Yeah. I feel like I could sell panties for a living.
I definitely could.
Yeah. Just sell them on eBay. You're like, yeah, these are Selma Hayek's. Yeah. All right, I probably should have brought up this. Nick, which Thor movie is this? Is this the third one?
This is the third Thor movie.
Why is it good?
I don't know. I haven't seen why is the trailer good or why is the movie good? The movie hasn't come out yet. But this is... We're leading into the Infinity Wars, so... Yeah.
How many movies until we actually get to the Infinity Wars?
How did this happen?
I think three more.
It's a long story.
Oh, wait, hold on. Is that Cate Blanchett?
Yes.
God damn it.
Asgard is dead.
Hi there.
Today,
tell me.
Oh my god.
A contender.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
You had a pause it.
Oh my god.
Yep. Jeff Goldblum is going to be, I think he's good for sure in this movie and probably the Infinity War movies, is how important his character may or may not be.
Quick, Loki, how do we find the Infinity Stones? Finds a way. I'm Jeff Goldblum. Now,
out of all your impressions, that's probably the most dead-on one.
Jeff Goldblum has a lot of... he's got Vince Vaughn syndrome going on. We've talked about this. Vince Vaughn is in every single movie. Jeff Goldblum has a lot of that going on. You could almost call it Jeff Goldblum syndrome. Because there's no movie where he isn't Jeff Goldblum. Like, even when he had a three-season run on Law & Order Criminal Intent, he was Detective Jeff Goldblum.
I've never seen that. I should look that up.
It was good. That was a good show. SVU gets all the love, and it's the only Law & Order still on, but Criminal Intent was really good. Trailer.
It's main event time.
Oh, you got a haircut.
And now, I give you...
Thor got a haircut. He's going to go Hunger Games on the bit. What?
Yes!
Yes, what?
We know each other. He's a friend from work.
Oh, come on.
But so the Incredible Hulk comes in and is going to fight Thor. Is there a story there?
I forget that you haven't seen any of these. I don't want to spoil.
We actually saw the first one with Natalie Portman.
Okay.
Yeah. Because we thought, oh, a rom-com. Natalie Portman's in it. Yeah. It's probably Black Swan.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, and the chick from Two Broke Girls was in it.
Yes, Kat Dennings.
Yeah.
Yes. I don't know if she'll be in this one. And the big deal with this third movie is that Natalie Portman is not going to be in it.
Oh.
They kind of taken it out of the story. I don't know if there was some mixed...
Well, was that like when they Katie Holmes wasn't in The Dark Knight?
The Dark Knight Returns?
Oh, just The Dark Knight.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And they're like, oh, yeah, Jake Gyllenhaal's sister. Just as good. Kind of glad they blew her up. Anyways, Fast and the Furious 8. So the thing that caught my eye was the stupid submarine scene when they're driving on the ice and then a submarine surfaces. Oh, snap. It's a nuclear submarine. No.
Oh, shit! We're gonna need a bigger truck.
The Rock. So who's the blonde chick?
It's Charlize Theron.
It's right under us. Get out the way!
Oh, Tyrese is telling The Rock to get out of the way because there's a submarine.
There's an excellent meme out there where they talk about how the first Fast and the Furious movie was like, remember when first movie they just was all about racing cars and now it's about, you know, attacking submarines. Yeah. And if you have the imagination for it and if you have enough budget to make all this stuff happen, obviously I don't think they got a real submarine. Or did they? That'd be sweet.
They easily could have. I'm sure Trump was like, I'll save the submarine at a huge discount. It's going to be huge because we're getting brand new ones. Now, I'm about to get launch the torpedoes.
Get us out of here! Why are you always yelling?
Look out! This isn't the torpedo one. Oh, that's unfortunate. Anyways, Thor.
Okay, so this movie's going to be a big deal because it's coming right after a movie I know you're going to see because I know at least you love it.
Guardians.
Guardians is coming out first in May.
Yeah.
And then this
May
one's 5th, 4th or 5th.
Yeah.
And this one's coming out in November. And if you kind of saw by the trailer, it's kind of hinting that it's looking kind of 80-ish, so they're thinking this could tie in with Guardians of the Galaxy, maybe, just because eventually Guardians of the Galaxy and the people from the Avengers are supposed to meet up in the Infinity Wars. So, as all these movies are, these individual movies...
wasn't Chris Pratt, like, in the late 70s, early 80s, when he was kidnapped, and then he's older, so you gotta think that it happens around the same time as the Avengers?
Yes.
I'm surprised that he found a tape deck in space because you know there's a tape deck in the spaceship.
Yep.
Yeah.
It's a loop plot hole. Wow.
Yeah. Doesn't really matter. Also, I'm pissed that Kurt Russell's the dad. I mean, this is a prime opportunity to actually get someone good. Like Kurt Russell just shows up in random franchises. Like he was in Fast and the Furious. Remember that?
Oh, yeah, that's what he was.
Five or six, doesn't matter. Just shows up.
I think he's going to be in this one, too. Kurt Russell was I know he doesn't get a lot of namesake, but he was a pretty big action star.
In Splash. Oh, Captain Ron. Yeah, that was a good one.
I love Captain Ron. but the two big ones that I think don't get enough attention are The Escape from L.A. and Escape from New York. Really big movies from the 80s.
That was on TV. I didn't watch it because I didn't want to. Tombstone. Yeah, I love Tombstone. He was Wyatt Earp.
Oh, yeah, that's right. So I think he's just he's not the Sylvester Stallone. He's not the Schwarzenegger, but almost there. Him and Goldie Hawn have been together for like the longest time. They just now split up.
For the longest time. Oh, that reminds me of, remember when David Spade was on SNL and he did the segment called Spade in America?
Yes, I think so.
And he was making fun of Kevin Costner's long-ass Wyatt Earp movie, which was like 3.5 hours. And he's like, so, yeah, I took the premiere of Japan to go see Wyatt Earp. And afterwards, he looked at me and said, why ain't so long? All right, let's do the news.
You are fake news.
Sir,
go ahead.
Can you...
George Bush doesn't care about black people.
I ain't got time to believe.
You can't handle
reveal the truth.
The news with Uncle Nick.
All right, Nick. Speaking of premieres of Asia, what's the first story, Nick?
Yeah, how would you... probably the biggest story in America right now, and news is still kind of coming up with this, so I bet we'll come back to it. But if you've been on the internet, you've seen the passenger on a United flight from Chicago going to Louisville, Kentucky, was kind of an interesting one, where a customer was forcibly dragged from his seat and incredibly injured. And of course... And, of course, the big thing is that it's 2017. Everyone has smartphones. Yeah. So this is all videotaped, and it's huge right now.
Now, this was weeks after their whole, United's whole legging issue. You know, when people were flying on United passes, like 10-year-old girl couldn't wear leggings. And then it's funny. The outrage over that is just as bad as this. And it just shows that people are either at 0 or 11 all the time on the outrage meter. And here's how, all right, so more of the backstory. The flight was overbooked, as a lot of flights are, because you assholes don't necessarily show up to all your flights, and the airline wants to make sure that they're always booked. And what always happens is if they're overbooked, then they start giving out the vouchers. And it's fine, especially if you're, you know, if you're on a vacation, if you're going for a business meeting or for business purposes, you definitely have to be there when you have to be there. But if you're on vacation and, you know, it's like a, you know, 3 hours, they're bumping you back. You were on the red eye, but then they'll put you at the 11 o'clock one and you get 200, 300 bucks in your pocket. Why the hell not? But this one was a late night flight and started off at 400 bucks, no takers. Then they upped it to 800 bucks, no takers. And then they just went to the computer and beep, bop, 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 boop, randomly selected a passenger. Oh, I love how this went racial right away, because I didn't know right away that the doctor was Asian. But then, of course, all the social justice warriors get on like, this is racial profiling. And then I'm like, hey, hold on. You can't be racist against the Asian. We're not participating in this. We opted out of this. We unchecked that box. You can only be racist against black people and Latinos. We've established this. Leave us alone. And also showing how big of pussies we are nowadays. So we're watching, we got this YouTube clip up of the guy getting dragged off the plane. And it's really nothing doing. Like, we've all been dragged. Well, I'm sure most of us have been dragged out of a bar in a similar situation, so it's really nothing doing. But, of course, there has to be a warning. The following footage may be disturbing, where it's just a grown man refusing to get up and then acting like a 2-year-old child and going boneless and then screaming like an 8-year-old girl, like a stuck pig. Yeah. It's all right. Let's watch so I can get pissed off more. Did you hear it?
No.
Yeah. Every single video where there's some violence going on, the... Hey, guy.
Oh, funny.
He's right there. Full circle on the show. And he had been warned like 28 times. Hey, sir, it's time to go. And then... He kept saying, no, I'm not. I doctor. I got to go see patients in Louisville. Apparently, I don't know if this is confirmed, because I've heard of both ways where they looked up the wrong doctor, but apparently he's kind of a sketchy doctor, like giving out bad scripts and whatnot. But that's really immaterial. But as a grown man, first off, don't scream. Now, you're a grown man. You don't scream like this, all right? Just straight up don't scream like this. Plus, have a little dignity, man. Like, maybe he was looking for the lawsuit, because he's going to get a chunk of change out of this. The lawyers will go after United. They'll go after the security company. But, you know, by the 28th time they ask you, sir, you were randomly drawn, please come with us off the plane, just go. Otherwise, you are going to get this. And by the time this happens, you kind of deserve it.
There's so many thoughts with this. Was this the right thing to do? I don't know. Obviously, United is going to get all the backlash for this. And it's, you know, and I'm not playing favoritism for either side of this. United does need to work on maybe a better system for getting their stewardess to different locations. You know, and
yeah, because, I'm sorry, this is all about four crew that had to be in Louisville, so they kicked four people off.
Yes. And, you know, I've seen websites that were saying that, you know, they were offering up to $1,000. I mean, yeah. You know, quite a bit of money, you know, to miss a flight. And, yeah. And you know, right away I was thinking, you know, do you really need to be in Louisville that bad? Yeah. And then, no one
needs to be in Northern Kentucky that bad. And here's my whole thing. What the airline should have done, instead of sending in these goons in jeans and a pullover, is go full Metal Jacket on the bit and use the psychology of the room against the person picked. So in Full Metal Jacket, Gomer Pyle, played by Vincent D'Onofrio, speaking of Law and Order Criminal Intent fame, was a really bad recruit. It's terrible. And Arlie Ermey, the drill instructor, the DI, singled him out and made the entire platoon do additional exercises because he was such a big screw-up, right? So what they should have done in a very Machiavellian, passive-aggressive manner, be like, hello, flight 3, blah, blah, blah. This is your captain speaking, and the gentleman in seat E8 or E3, he is the one who's been drawn to get off the plane. And we've asked him politely many times to have him removed from the plane, but until he gets up and leaves, we're sort of stuck here. And that's where we are. There will be no drink service. We will not be taxiing back to the terminal. And so here we are. So do what you will.
I almost would have respected United if they would have just canceled this flight entirely and be like, so we have one sore loser who...
Excuse me, flight. This is your captain speaking again. The flight will be canceled, and there will be no reimbursements given out if the gentleman in seat B3 does not get up and move his ass. His Asian, scream like a little girl ass.
And this is just a shame because there's a lot of news articles coming out. I said this was just earlier this week, and I've seen things where United is now, like, they're offering refunds to everyone on the plane
which
now.
Is so stupid. Like, under the guise of, we're sorry if you were inconvenienced or traumatized. It's like, bullshit. You're telling me the guy in the back of the plane was traumatized by this? He was probably just pissed off. He's like, oh, man, I can't get any closer. I can't get any YouTube hits off of this. Come on, man.
This is just... It's getting worse, and I seen an article about this guy had a concussion from it.
Good.
And now there's going to be a big lawsuit, and a lot of people are pissed at United, and it's going to be a while before this thing blows over.
I don't care. This should be more commonplace. We've gone completely limp dick as a society, and I sort of like stuff like this, and like don't lead with it right away. Don't be like, sir, you've been drawn. Please come with us. Okay, let me grab my. No, let's not go there. But by the 30th time you politely ask anyone to do anything, which they're going to be required to do anyways, so don't be like, oh, well, what girl is rejecting you? Then you're just going to drag her off into the cave? No, we're not talking about that. But we're talking about this guy was going to have to move anyways before the flight took off. And God, a little prissy drama queen is like, someone just kill me. Just kill me. Oh, we gladly would have killed you. No worry. Or have that plane, going back to what we said,
this is your captain speaking. We've been on the tarmac now for the better part of 4 hours, and the gentleman in seat B3 still will not leave. So the crew will now be eating and drinking in front of you. We have some delicious Lou Malnati's deep dish Chicago style pizza since we're still in Chicago, even though we're supposed to be in Northern Kentucky. And I know that you guys are all hungry and very thirsty, but tough shit. Ask B3 to leave.
You will get things going on real fast. Or better part, put a. I don't know if they have this, or maybe it's just in movies. They should put it like a electromagnet damper on. So that people can't use their phones. Or, no, a signal jammer. Yeah, so, like, no Wi-Fi, no network coverage, just completely, like, phones still work, but just nada. That would be so great.
To get the story towards a close, the main thing I think we got to get out of this is that would this story have been as big as it was if there was no video shot? If it was, if this was done back in 1993 or 90, you know, in the early 90s before smartphones, do you think this would be as hectic, as crazy with now modern social media and modern cameras?
Well, we're at sort of a crux point because 10 years ago, there would have been little video unless someone had their digital camera. Remember digital cameras? It's 5 megapixels. This is great. This cost me $300. But now we're getting to the point where everything's going to be videotaped, whether it be people on their smartphones or security cameras or drone footage. Yeah, everything's going to be on tape. But the thing about it is that I think we're also getting numb to social media outrage and the news calling everything a backlash, rage on social media tonight. Whereas, like, 100 jabronis were bitching on a Facebook page. Yeah, that doesn't count. And I think we're sort of tuning that out, too. And do you remember when social media started being a thing, like Facebook started getting big, Twitter, and then businesses were like very knee jerk whenever there was a couple hundred negative tweets or a couple hundred negative Facebook comments. And then now I think companies and sponsors are starting to be like, oh yeah, this doesn't mean anything. Yeah, so deuces. Because there was probably an equal amount of backlash on this as there was Cecil the Lion Killer guy.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that one.
Yeah. And you know what? He's still in business. He still has new customers. You know why? Because people forget. They get bored. They moved on. And people still fly United. Yeah, I love people's like, I'm boycotting United. I will never fly United again. Bullshit. If you need to go from Chicago to Atlanta, you're going to get the cheapest flight possible at the most convenient time. And if it's United, your ass is going to be in United 9 years from now. Like, I understand people doing the short term is like, I'm not going to fly United this weekend. Yeah. Talk to me in 5 years.
Oh, sorry. I was just going to say there were people who were posting pictures and videos on Twitter with them cutting up their frequent flyer miles for United, like not flying them again, snip, 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 and then they cut up their credit card or whatever.
Well, what they don't understand is that them not using the miles is beneficial for United. That means they don't have to give out free flights. Hey, congratulations, make yourself feel better, even though you don't really think these things out. Assholes. Although I have boycotted Spirit because of what they've done anything. They're just terrible. That is all. Like quality will still speak overall. Yeah.
Of course.
Let's do one more. New Wolves logo.
All right. Let me pull that out up here. I did not have that one up. Okay. With the Wolf season coming to an end, the Timberwolves have released a picture of a new logo. I believe this is like their third or fourth one since coming in. Was it 1987, and kind of a throwback to the original a little bit, but I mean, to me, the original one was the best. But you have the gray, blue color scheme, green eyes.
Green eyes, you're the one.
Minnesota.
More of the polygonish type of shape of a wolf.
Yeah, there's like a 3-minute hype video we'll have in the show. Now, we were having this debate last night. Is Slug the name of the guy, or is Atmosphere the name of the guy?
I heard it on the show. I thought Atmosphere was the name of the guy.
I thought Atmosphere was the name of the guy, too. Except, by the looks of this, it would be like Fred Durst from Limp Bizkit. Slug, Atmosphere. I don't know. Either way, we're not going to watch the whole video, but it's pretty hype. And then it gets to the new logo at the end, and it's like, a lot has been made of it. Mainly because it looks exactly like the logo from the SB Nation Wolves blog, Canis Hoopus. I understand like it's everyone's default setting online to not like change or think things dumb, but this is a bad logo. Like, this is not good. Honestly, they should have gone to a complete old school logo. Everyone loves the old school logo, old school colors, old school uniforms even, and I think people would have been a lot more happy. But this is like, meh. And they're hyping this up for months. It's like, oh, April 14th. Why not? April 11th, 12th, whatever. We'll have a new logo and check it out. And then it's like, it sucks.
They're just, why make a new logo anyway? It's a marketing campaign. You're going to make money off this because all the Timberwolves fans Who
gotta
bought,
buy new gear.
Yeah, they have to buy new gear. They buy new clothes. I wasn't at the game, and I didn't watch this video. Is new uniforms, are they available to see yet?
Not new uniforms yet, which is also clunky, too. It's like, oh, we got the new logo. You'll see the new uniforms later. It's like, psh. And then they're selling the old stock for 75% off. So they're getting it either way.
Okay. So if you're a fan of the old logo, I mean, hell, you know.
I didn't care what the old logo was. I like the Kevin Garnett era, like 03, 04 uniforms that had the trees on the trim. That was awesome. Those are good.
To me, my favorite would always be the 87, that like blocky wolf just kind of staring at you, and that was all you need. And that was
89. It was the first year.
89. Okay. Yeah.
They played the first season in the Metrodome, too, which is just hilarious.
Ridiculous. Atmosphere.
Yeah.
Is the name of the group. The two rappers or rapper producer is Slug and Ant.
Oh, well, what the shit? This entire time I thought the guy's name was Atmosphere.
Oh, yeah. No, so did I. I think a lot of people are, but... You know, which we shouldn't, because this is Minneapolis. This is the Minneapolis band.
We're watching the Lakers and the Wolves circa 1990.
What color is the uniform? Are those just white?
They're just in white, yeah. No, those are like cut and clean. Play the Metrodome. AC Green. Oh, by the way, I wonder if AC Green has gotten laid yet. I don't know if he's married. He's a famous virgin.
Oh.
Which is important, I guess.
Yeah. Okay. That's neat. I was never a big T-Wolves fan, though. I wasn't really? A big. Not really. Even though my brother played the basketball growing up, and one of my cousins was really into it. A couple of them were pretty good in the high school.
Yeah. Aren't you from a family of Wolves fans? Like, didn't your cousin propose at a Wolves game?
Yes. Yep. Yep. Anthony, my cousin Anthony,
boo.
Did this year.
Anthony, I'm sure you're cool as shit, but still, boo.
Some people can be fans of it. It's just their thing. We have hockey friends, hockey family, you know, baseball and football.
Yeah. Oh, God. Yeah, watch the hockey game. I'm sorry, everyone. I jinxed us. That's the news.
The news with Uncle Nick.
From the entire Channel 4 news team, I'm Veronica Corningstone.
And I'm Ron Burgundy. Go f*** yourself, San Diego.
Ah! What you got going on this weekend, Nick?
It's Easter weekend for me, so I know you celebrated last weekend. I'm doing
actually, we're celebrating this weekend too.
Damn, okay. Well, you're busy. Okay,
two Easters, all the ham. How much ham? All of it. Yeah,
lucky.
That's cool. Well, where are you going? What are you doing?
Spending time with family in Roseville, so I'm pretty excited for that. I always lay out the Easter eggs for my nieces, they get really excited for it.
Oh, well, that'll be fun.
Yeah.
And if you get too drunk at Easter, which Nick is apt to do, get around town with Lyft, bullshow.co/Lyft. LYFT, 15 bucks off your first couple of rides. As I yawn. Bullshow.co/Lyft, because you want to get around. Also, you don't want to be assaulted. And Lyft, they're pretty good about that. They have nice little background checks. And also, a lot of their, whenever I ride with Lyft, it's always cool because their drivers usually have like mints or like those little bottled waters in the back. It's nice. It's a nice little touch. As I get around town for cheap. Because I can get downtown from here with Lyft for like 20 bucks when it's off time, which is pretty good.
Oh, yeah, that's really good. I'm going to use it for my friend's bachelor party this week.
Bull
next month.
Show.co/Lyft. LYFT. And just like Nick, we're just saving you 15 bucks off your first couple of rides, baby. All right, get the show on iTunes, Stitcher, iHeartRadio, and YouTube. We got some good sauce up there. If you enjoy us, tell a friend, spread the word, add to the Jerome Homie Army, just like Nicholas Jerome Assange. Well, what's your middle name?
David.
What's social security number?
586. Hey.
Well, hold on. What are the first nine numbers?
56. Hey. No.
8675309. Thanks, producer Allie, for making me not sound so stupid today. But for Nick, I'm Andy Carlson saying, and Young, sayonara and bye bye. We'll talk to you tomorrow. Well, no, Monday. Close enough. Whatever.
Thanks for listening to Bull with Andy Carlson.
Minnesota's 87th best daily podcast. Download the show on iTunes. Everyone's middle name is Jerome.